small ball game?
You just got to fly around. You got to communicate. James is going to create a lot of eyes on him because of what he's doing this year as far as scoring the basketball. But Russ, definitely deal with Russ is capable of doing. We've seen it a lot throughout his career. He was wonderful tonight.
Your first look at Covington on that team, and he's guarding you a few times. What did you think they looked like with him on the team?
As expected. He was brought in to create space, knock down open shots, and guard some of the perimeter offensive players on the end.
Is it frustrating to lose when you guys do hold James to sort of a substandard night?
No, you can't look at it like that because we're all NBA players. It means absolutely nothing. It's not frustrating. We want to continue to get better. We don't like to lose, especially in our home building, but nothing frustrating about our effort.
Small ball in doses is nothing new, and in your Miami Heat teams were part of the initial wave of popularizing it around the league. But to see it, a franchise commit so much to it, just your opinion as a basketball watcher, a basketball mind, what's your
And that was before us. Don Nelson did it a lot in Golden State when it was going with like Baron Davis and Matt Barnes and Steven Jackson and Jay Rich and all those guys. That first round series when they beat the number one seed Dallas, they were playing small ball, so it didn't start with us. They helped popularize it. I know we always want to talk about the big three, and now we kind of made the big three popular. There's a lot of things happened before us, so. But that's what Houston is doing, and it looked good for them tonight for sure.
Can you talk about the defense against the smaller lineup?
What do you?
Your guys' defense.
It's tough because you have to, control Russ' ability to get into the paint, which he did a lot tonight, but also be able to control their perimeter shooting, and we didn't do a very good job of both. We allowed Russ to. Getting to the interior a lot, and then we gave them 19 threes as well. So you can't give up both.
Part of the idea of using a lineup like this is taking advantage of Russ's speed. Everybody can move quickly. At 31 years old, is he still just as fast as he was when you started playing him 20 or however old
of course,
he came in the league?
And smarter. That's what it's all about. As we continue to get older in our age in this game, but we continue to get smarter. Russ is just a much more complete basketball player right now. His ability to use his speed, use his strength, but also do things with his brain helps out a lot.
When he's going off like that, does it affect your guys' flow on the other side offensively?
No, because he was going off all night and we still had pretty good flow. I had a bad late turnover. He got a shot blocked in the post. And they were able to capitalize off of that, but we had pretty good flow offensively still.
Last two questions, please.
LeBron, with earlier today with doing the draft, and when you have the option of picking so many different all-stars, what's your thought process of what you're looking for?
You kind of go for best available, but also who will fit the mold of your team and how you want to play. That's what it boiled down to.
LeBron, you've said that you like this group the way it is. Obviously, no moves at the trade deadline. Darren Collison was at the game tonight, sitting next to Genie. He's been linked to this team. Is that a move, an addition that you think would help this group?
I don't know. I don't like talking fantasy basketball. I've never been one to talk fantasy basketball. We'll see what happens, but I don't really have too much to comment on that. For sure.
Thanks, everyone.